The people who sat in darkness have seen a great light. And for those who lived in the land where death cast its shadow, a great light I have come as a light to shine in this dark world, so that all who put their trust in me will no longer remain in darkness.
Who among you fears the Lord and obeys his servant? If you are walking in darkness without a ray of light, trust in the Lord and rely on God, who said, "Let there be light in the darkness," has made us understand that this light is the brightness of the glory of God that is seen in the face of Jesus.
I am the light of the world. If you follow me, you won't be stumbling through the darkness.
Because you will have the light that leads to life. Because you will have the light that leads to life.
Those things are coming to pass. And when you see prophecies happening, you know that come from God. You know without a doubt. I told Debbie a while ago, I said, when the very first time that I come down that road to Debbie's house to a ladies' meeting 3 years ago, I said, I felt the presence of God, just like an overwhelming presence of God, come upon me. He knew exactly where we were going to be today. He knew exactly, Charlie, that you were going to get this house, that you were going to open it up to us until, you know, until he opens that door. We know that we've got what he wants, each one of us, and we will. God will take care of it. I know he will. I'm just excited.
Leave it to me. I know a place where we can go to lay the troubles down, eating your soul. I know a place where mercy flows, take the stains, make you whiter than snow. Like a tide, it is rising up deep inside a current that moves and makes it come alive. Living water that brings the dead to life. Oh, we're going down to the river, down to the river, down to the river to pray. Let's get water.
Fear of God.